Welcome to this demonstration on how to receive and label goods using GS1 SSCC labels. Today, we will explore the various scenarios and procedures involved in this process. There are several reasons to use GS1 SSCC labels for your pallets. There are different scenarios as to why you would want to label your pallets yourself. For instance, certain suppliers might not be able to label pallets correctly, and by labeling the pallets yourself, you can ensure that all goods have a unified labeling. A consequence of labeling your pallets with SSCC numbers is that you get the traceability of that pallet inside the warehouse. By generating a pallet ID or SSCC number and assigning it to the pallet, you can have full traceability of the pallet's movements within the warehouse. In order to be able to generate GS1 SSCC labels, you will need a company prefix and a number series registered with GS1. Once you have a number series, you can add it in Ongoing. By going to Administration and Number Series, we can see that in this system we have two different number series set up. One for generating waybill numbers, and another one for generating SSCC numbers. A number series consists of a start number and an end number, which defines the range, and a current number, which acts as a counter to keep track of our current position within this range. Each generated number will increment the current number by one. To set which number series should be used on a specific goods owner, you can go to Administration and Goods Owners, edit the goods owner, click Show All Fields, and navigate down to Number Series. For this goods owner, the Number Series SSCC is already selected. Let's receive some pallets and generate some SSCC numbers and GS1 labels. In this scenario, we are going to receive two unlabeled pallets by registering the article number, the batch number, the expiry date, and the quantity. We will then print a GS1 SSCC label to put on the pallet. In the purchase order list, we select a purchase order and press Arrived under Functions. This makes it ready for reception with a handheld device. Notice that it changed status to Arrival Space. We go into our scanning module by pressing Scanning and pressing Inbound against an order. Here, we can see that we have one purchase order available for reception. That's the one that we placed in the Arrival Space status. We select it. We start by choosing the article. We can do this either by inputting an article number, scanning an EIN barcode, or selecting it from a list. I'll select it from the list here. We get a match on the article, and we are asked to input a batch number. I'll come up with a batch, ABC. Next is asking me for an expiry date. I'll input an expiry date. And lastly, the quantity on the pallet. On this pallet, there is 80 pieces of soda. So I'll input 80. Next, we are going to put this pallet to a location. I'll put it on A1. And the first pallet with 80 pieces on it has been received. The pallet was received, and we automatically print the pallet label on your label printer. It is also possible to manually generate the labels afterwards and print them, which is what I will have to do in this case, since I don't have a printer service installed. I'll receive the last pallet, and we're done with the purchase order. So I'll select the article again, input a new batch, DBA, another expiry date, and the quantity, 80 pieces on this pallet as well. I'll put this pallet on a different location, A2. The entire purchase order has been received. We press close order, and we're done. To manually generate the labels, we go to Warehouse, Update Goods Info, We filter on inbound date to get the latest inbound. We see here that we have two lines without any SSCC numbers. These are the pallets that we just received. By checking them and pressing the GS1 SSCC pallet label, we generate the labels containing the information that we entered, the batch number, the quantity, the best before date, and we also generated an SSCC number from our number series here. Here is the second pallet label. The SSCC number was generated from our number series at the moment of label creation, and we can also see the SSCC number here. Going back to the purchase order list and expanding and looking at the details, we can see all goods information we added and the newly generated SSCC numbers. Thank you for watching this demonstration on receiving and labeling goods with GS1 SSCC labels.